Today we're asking, is the Netherlands becoming a narco state? When a nation starts soul searching, it's usually because someone has died. In September of 2019, the Dutch lawyer Dirk Viersum was gunned down outside his family home in suburban Amsterdam. Viersum's specialist area was organized crime, gang activity, the drug trade. But Dutch lawyers like him aren't used to fearing for their lives. Being shot dead hasn't really been an occupational hazard for lawyers in the Netherlands, in the same way it has in, say, Mexico or Colombia. All that changed the morning Viersum was assassinated just yards from his doorstep as he left for work, seconds after saying goodbye to his wife. It's widely believed that the murder was ordered by international drug lords. There's a common misconception that drugs are legal in the Netherlands. They aren't, but some of them are tolerated. After decades of tolerance, Dirk Viersum's homeland is seen by an international generation of wreckheads as the world capital of getting high. But now, after a wave of chaos and violence, people are asking, is the Netherlands Europe's first narco state? First things first, before we get into it, we should probably pin down what a narco state actually is. This is how the IMF define it. They say a narco state is a nation where all legitimate institutions become penetrated by the power and wealth of traffickers. Maybe it's easier just to say that a narco state is any country where drug-selling gangsters basically call the shots over the police, the politicians, and the justice system. You know, like Colombia in the 1970s and 80s. No doubt you're already familiar with this guy and his rags-to-riches success story. Using little more than a relentless torrent of bribery, cocaine, and violence, Pablo Escobar managed to turn his sleepy homeland into history's most famous narco state. Then there's Guinea-Bissau. First, decades of conflict hollowed out its economy. Then, in 2005, some strange white powder washed up on the beach. The fishermen who found it didn't know what it was exactly, but it did come in handy for marking out the white lines on a nearby football pitch. But then one day, two Latin Americans arrived in a plane carrying $1 million. As news of this hospitality spread, many more Latin Americans started showing up in Guinea-Bissau. They rapidly turned the country into a huge sorting office for drugs bound for Europe and North America. And then in 2008, Guinea-Bissau was declared Africa's first narco state by the UN. Mexico, Afghanistan, Bolivia, Venezuela, Albania, all countries that have been branded narco states in the last few decades. So now that we know what a narco state is, we can start sussing out if the Netherlands actually is one. To help, we're joined by the Dutch journalist, Bo Hanna. Bo, what's the latest on the Dirk Viersum case?
Before he was murdered in 2019, Dirk Viersum was preparing to represent a man named Nabil Bakali in court. Bakali was a former gang member who had turned informant, and he was preparing to testify against two of the Netherlands' most wanted men, Ridouan Taghi and Said Razouki.
Who are Ridouan Taghi and Said Razouki?
Ridouan Taghi and Said Razouki are the bosses of a Dutch cocaine trafficking gang named Mokro Mafia, due to the fact that most of its members are of Moroccan descent, and they are suspected of a string of murders, including Dirk Viersum's. And Taghi is seen as kingpin, and Razouki is actually second in command.
Have these men been arrested by the Dutch police?
Taghi was wanted for years prior to the killing of Dirk Viersum. He was finally tracked down in Dubai in December 2019 and is now in custody. Razouki was untraceable for years too and was eventually found even further afield in Colombia in 2020. He was actually found in the hometown of Pablo Escobar called Medellin.
It's not just the death of Dirk Viersum that's got people worried about law and order losing its grip on the Netherlands. Here's some more evidence that could suggest the country is turning into a narco state. 6 weeks after Viersum's death, another Dutch lawyer named Philippe Scholl was shot in the leg while out walking his dog. And earlier, in 2018, Ridouan Bakali, the brother of the informant Viersum was preparing to defend, was killed by a gunman. It's not only guns. Hand grenades are becoming an increasingly common sight on the streets of Amsterdam as gangs seek to shut down rival businesses, mostly coffee shops. And in this CCTV footage from 2016, you can see the convicted killer and drug dealer Martin Cook almost getting his head blown off in the Dutch capital. It seems the assassin's gun jams at the crucial moment. Kok doesn't even notice what's happened. However, his luck didn't last. Security cameras captured Kok being gunned down hours later in the car park of a sex club. Ironically, Kok had been targeted not for his own crimes, but for exposing those of others. After he was released from prison, he transformed himself into a crime writer, and people had repeatedly tried to kill him because he'd brazenly published the full names of drug traffickers and hired guns on his blog. It's not like the mainstream media has been spared this kind of treatment either. In June of 2018, someone attacked the offices of Panorama magazine with a rocket launcher. A few days later, the lobby of the country's largest national newspaper, De Telegraaf, was ram-raided by a burning van. Both outlets came under attack after publishing stories about Ridwan Taghi. Illegal drugs production in the Netherlands is even terrorizing the environment. In the southern region of Brabant, constant dumping of the toxic chemicals left over from MDMA production is killing trees and animals, as well as poisoning the water supply.
Deze weg is echt een van de synthetische drugsafvallen dumping hotspots in deze buurt. Heel milieuschade veroorzaakt.
En deze waterloop die voert het water naar de stadsgrachten. En hier heb ik dus al een paar keer een synthetische drugsdumping in gehad. En hier lagen een stuk of 10 vaten, grote vaten van een paar honderd liter naar beneden gegooid. Mm-hmm. Dus daar in de bocht ligt dan gewoon vol met dode vissen. Maar dit is een plek waar we een van de meest dramatische drugsdumpingen hebben gehad in Brabant. Er lag een heel groot vat waar 1000 liter drugsafval van de bodem in liep. En je kan het nog steeds zien, bijvoorbeeld deze bomen, die hebben natuurlijk ook al drugsafval meegekregen. En dat blad dat krult nog steeds raar en dat gaat in de loop van de zomer dood.
Deze hele boom?
Ja, zeker. Ja.
What does all of this chaos and death, this risk and hard graft, tell us about the Netherlands? Well, for one thing, the drug market there must be worth shit tons. Just as mind-boggling is the amount of drugs being exported from the Netherlands. In 2017, synthetic drugs worth £16 billion were produced there. Ecstasy, cocaine, speed, LSD, crystal meth, you name it, it's being synthesized in huge quantities in the Netherlands. Lately, there's been a surge in the use of GHB, as the deadly drug works its way out from the Netherlands into the clubbing mainstream.
We've just come to Groningen, which is in the northern Netherlands. We're here to meet a dealer who sells GHB, and according to him, this area is going through a bit of a GHB epidemic, especially amongst the hardcore music scene, and the police have started to make it a priority. Is this the G?
This is it, yeah.
Out of all the stuff that you sell, which sells the most?
GHB, for sure. Most people I sell to are pretty heavy users.
Okay.
And they'll fucking use it in church, anywhere.
Do you know people who have died from it?
Yeah, maybe around 5-6 people I know have died from it, from overdosing on it.
How popular is G in the Netherlands?
It's absolutely an epidemic. So many people using it nowadays, comparing to a few years back.
Lonely lads in skeleton masks knocking out homebrew GHB to GABA ravers aren't going to turn the Netherlands into a narco state single-handedly. But what's increasingly clear is that the country is becoming the nerve center of the global drug trade. For many international kingpins, whether they're Moroccan or the Mexicans who run the infamous Sinaloa cartel, the Netherlands is the number one gateway to the lucrative European market. The thing is, this has been the case for a while now. It's only really been in the last few years, since the criminal underworld started impacting mainstream society, that people have been wondering if the Netherlands is out of control. Something felt like it might be happening to change this in 2020. The police took over a secret international phone network used by organized criminals. It's called EncroChat. It's a bit like WhatsApp for murderous gangsters. As we speak, the EncroChat hacks have led to a string of raids and over 100 arrests. Police have seized 20 million euros, 1,200 kilograms of crystal meth, 10 tons of cocaine, and have taken out 19 meth labs. Near Rotterdam, the police even discovered 7 shipping containers that had been turned into custom-built prison cells and a torture chamber, featuring a dentist chair, handcuffs, pliers, and scalpels. Arrests and busts have been made not just in the Netherlands, but Ireland, the UK, Spain, and Sweden too. Given how globalized the modern narcotics trade is, perhaps this is the start of the Dutch freeing themselves from the grip of criminals like Ridwan Taghi. Of course, the Netherlands is different from the other countries on the narco state list. It's affluent, It's Northern European. It hasn't recently been the site of horrible guerrilla warfare. And despite brushes with the far right, politically it's fairly stable. Comparing it with Colombia at the height of Escobar is going too far. No one's blown up a plane yet, and so far only one severed head's been found in the street. If the EncroChat raid showed the extent of the problem, perhaps they also hinted its solution. The murder of Dirk Viersum might well have been chilling for the Dutch, but despite what some in the country fear, there's still a long way to go before the Netherlands can think of itself as a bona fide narco state.
We'd like to congratulate Drugs for winning the war on drugs.